I remember my first day going to visit Norton & Sons on Savile Row. Yeah, I felt quite scared.
Intimidated.
Intimidated to go onto Savile Row because it felt like such a mysterious place. Met some of the guys that had been working on Savile Row for many years. And I was just so fascinated to find out who they'd met, asking them question after question.
Drive them mad.
Yeah, drive them mad. At the same time, I think anyone who's really passionate about what they do, they're natural educators as well.
And I can speak for hours on this subject, literally, because I've got many stories about my apprenticeship. I used to be at home sewing when I was at school, and I'd narrow my trousers sitting in the toilet because my mother wouldn't let me wear drainpipe trousers. And so when I went into a tailor, I just loved it. The current climate in Savile at the moment is very mixed. There's lots of mixed messages there, and it's all partly due to the demise of the master craftsman, in my opinion. No one objects to people coming into the street, but providing they can contribute to the heritage of Savile Row in some respects, and not just come there with a name in order to legitimise their brands.
The main part of my job is actually looking after the ready-to-wear. The best thing to do is to take the best of the knowledge of all these highly skilled craftspeople based at the house on Savile Row, and then couple that with all of the advancements in modern technology. And yeah, I mean, that's obviously the difference now that I'm essentially working for a heritage brand now that Hardy, the name of Hardy Ames is such a massive name, and what he achieved, and Hardy himself being such a stylish,
very
man.
Elegant man, and so pro young people. Mm. The big houses today, whether it be men's or women's wear, they're always at the colleges to get the talent and bring the talent into their own company.
Well, it keeps it an exciting place because all the most notable men in history and currently and in the future probably they all have this desire to look great, and for us it's sort of supply and demand. I suppose you have to listen to or be aware of what people want. I believe there will be always a desire for people to want highly skilled craftspeople to make beautiful clothes for them.
And stick to the principles of Savile Row, and you've got it.